Hey everyone, breakfast vlog for Monday the 29th of October 2018, just beaming in from Antarctica. It's really nice down there right now this time of the year, coming into summer. So we're getting the beach umbrellas out and getting ready, us and all the emperor penguins, I believe. Anyway, I could be wrong. What to talk about? Well, what not to talk about, eh? I mean, my goodness gracious, the weekend goes by and it doesn't leave us lacking in information or stuff to talk about. And last night at our Antarctic discussions, we were talking about mental health. We were having a dinner party last night. Gotta love dinner parties. Dinner parties, I think, are an essential thing. I can remember. They go way back. You can look at old movies and people would have dinner parties and people would come over and, you know, you'd have a couple of beverages or you'd have a couple of cigarettes and marijuana, whatever turned your fancy, and it wouldn't be an unruly, unholy hell. It would be a dinner party where a discussion would happen, and I had two this weekend which were absolutely fantastic. You talk, and so a lot of discussion about what was going on in the world. So, dinner parties, wow, should have more of them. I should start having them. I think they're great, you know, Scrabble parties, whatever. But anyway, so what were we talking about? Well, we were talking about mental health, of course, because of what's been going on lately in the news. And we'll talk about... we were talking about the incident with the shooting, the most recent shooting at the synagogue, and then the postal situation. And then we went back and we're talking about the hopelessness of... I keep referencing back to that fella, the aircraft mechanic who took the plane and flew around and then either was crashed or he crashed or was crashed or was shot out of the sky. I don't know. It's not important, but we'll speak to the recording that was made of him and the ATC and the sense of hopelessness that was in this guy's voice. And that's what I wanted to talk about today, because I was trying to piece together, you know, I was trying to make some sense out of this senseless situation that we've got going on. And it's very hard to make sense out of senseless situations, you know, and look, it's obvious to me that these people who had these issues were not, at that moment in their lives, were not playing with a full deck, okay? Now, I've had moments where I've come unglued. You've probably had moments when you've come unglued yourself. And it's not the rule, it's just the exception. But for whatever reason, you didn't snap, or, you know, you got through it for whatever reason, and it seems to me that with the mental health issues today that people are falling through the cracks and they're not able to deal with it. So when the big push comes, that like when I had my breakdown back 15 years ago, I was unable to withstand the pressures that were exerted upon me, and I broke. And that's fortunately for me, I had a lot of avenues and I had a lot of outs. I had a lot of things in the military that were afforded to me that could help me try and get out of the mire, the muck, and the abysmal hole that I found myself in. I'm one of the lucky ones, okay? And then I was also investigated on a lot of other things about lately with mental health and talking about, you know, like I just said, like, at that moment, you know, our cheese had slipped off the cracker, but it wasn't always the case. So I'm trying to figure out, okay, well, why are they unable to process, or why were they unlucky and not being able to process or whatever? And I'm noticing that with a lot of things, it has to do with percentages. And we were talking about, you know, percentages of intellect in the planet, and yes, okay, there could be people who are on the lower scale that could be easily or more easily duped and unable to get out of the mire that they're in, and we could say that, and we can do that, and that could cover a small percentage. But what I'm trying to get at is, like, what is making people's cheese slip off the cracker? Like, it's worse. Our stressors seem to be worse. There seem to be more stressors in life Whereas we were told in the future that it would get easier and easier and easier, but it seems to be more and more strife. So we were talking about that because it's quite obvious to me that if you go into, if you're sending pipe bombs in the mail and you're all disgruntled, then you've got a screw loose. If you're going into a place and you're shooting everybody, then you're being irrational. So, but it has nothing to do with, you know, what was in the milk or whatever. There's a collective insanity that's going around that's pushing people and making them do irrational things. They're acting on their irrationality. They're not, at that, when they get to that point, you know, in our history, you know, let's say 50 years ago, you'd go have a drink or you'd go have a cigarette or you'd go have somewhere. There would be an avenue so that you wouldn't go crazy, you know. And I believe that those avenues have been taken away now so that people's cheese is completely coming off the cracker and they're acting irrationally because they if you can hearken back to that fella in the airplane, it comes down to the sense of hopelessness. Like, if you, even if you have all the tools, and you're unable, and you're able to process whatever's going on in your life, if inside of you, you have a sense of hopelessness, or you have no hope that even what you're doing is going to do any good, then yes, you may act irrationally. And that's what I've noticed lately with all of these irrational things that are happening. It seems that, you know, I'm not getting any results, so this is what's going to happen. And, you know, and it comes down the pipe for a lot of things. You know, when you see a lot of the things going on with these groups of people running around, and it could be a collective, absolute collective insanity. That's what it seems like to me, like a group nutty think. You know, like you'll all be in your echo chambers and you go out and, like, you know, I always make the same joke, eh? Individuality is great as long as you do it in a group. So they're all getting together in their echo chamber with their craziness, and then they all bounce off each other and make each other more crazy, and then you get things like, if you know, hey, look, man, I've been there, you know, you get in your echo, like, it's like fandom, you know, you're a Montreal Canadiens fan, and that's just the way it goes, and then all your Montreal Canadiens fans get together, echo, 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 bounce, 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 the other team's Satan, you've got to burn their bus, you got to kill their fans, it's just the way it goes. I mean, it's all psychology, but we were desperate at the dinner party to figure out, like, because we were all going around. Is it Trump? Is it Clinton? Is it the collective consciousness of the world? Is it blue avians? What is it? You know, for me, it's just all the distraction and the getting away from what is important in our lives, our family. For me, spirituality, my relationship with my higher power, stuff like that. My relationship with Gaia, my relationship with my children, friends around me in this small community. Giving back, that's what makes me whole and makes me feel worthwhile. But man, oh man, I mean, you know, I have hope. Of course I have hope, because when I see good things happen, which are never broadcast, when I see, you know, communities in Florida coming together after the hurricane, some, not all, some, but I know that there is hope, that they're not all zombies, they're not all eating each other. Sure, you're gonna have pockets of that. But you're going to have the good stuff too. But the mental health issue is absolutely, and I've spoken to this before, it's at a fever pitch right now. And we're not having our dinner parties, for lack of a better term, to try and sort these things out. And that's what I love about, I'm listening to the guys online, I'm listening to mostly guys who are just talking. You know, you've got some that are investigative journalists that I would call. So a guy like Joe from the Carolinas, who's like digging in, figuring out what's going on. And then you've got another guy, like a fellow who just talks, feeling, emotion, stuff. C.W. Chanter, who is more on the, I wouldn't say the cerebral side, but like just more of the emotional side of it. You know, we've got the investigative journalists, but we need to have the investigative emotionalists, I guess, if that's what you want to call it. Did I just trademark another term? But that's the thing, you know. So I have hope, but I'm trying to figure, like, we're pushing people to the edge. We're pushing people right to the edge where, and there are very, a good number of people that are where they're right on the edge. That, like, right now, the pitch is at a fever, so that everybody's on the edge right now, so it's just not going to take much, you know. It's like the cat going along the table, you know. There's all kinds of things right on the end, ding, 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 and they're all going to get popped off. So, you know, we need to watch for that. We need to watch for people who are on the edge, and you can see them. That sense of hopelessness that when they're talking and they're like, you know, their hands are up in the air, and they're getting angry for no reason very quickly, you know. Things are happening, so. But yeah, it's something that has to be addressed. We can't ignore. You can't ignore mental health. You can't ignore a boiling pot of hot water in the back of your stove, and then just leave, and then hope that it sorts itself out. It's gonna blow. It's just the way it is. I mean, you know, this is why we have to look at these things. We have to really investigate. We need to really get to the crux. We need to get to right the nitty gritty. You know, we need to fix this, and that's what I'm trying to get at. So, I'm hoping you're all doing well. I'm rambling now. Mixed bag today. I saw blue sky there, but anyway, back to Antarctica. Peace to you and yours. Hope to see you on the flip side.